My name is Nic Lorenzen. I work at Northwell. I'm a lead developer for the Northwell Emerging Technology Innovation Team, also known as the NITI team. So, and as a day-to-day dev lead, I manage a small group of developers. We're a startup-like team, so we don't come with technical debt or any other, you know, legacy software. We're basically just trying to build products, most valuable products or MVP products, as quickly as possible using the best technology as possible. So I'm overseeing architecture, day-to-day dev lead stuff, proof of concepts, and working with users, making sure we get feedback and iterating appropriately. Traditionally, what happens is the health system goes off and buys a very expensive application that doesn't want to talk to other applications or uses a proprietary or old school style transport method. It's a nightmare. So with our challenge is really trying to put information together, but also to bridge communication gaps and collaboration issues and in a more controlled environment. So rather than doctors and nurses using their iPhones and iMessage for passing really sensitive information back and forth, we'd like to be able to present them information and let them make actions and collaborate on that information in a much more controlled and secure environment. So the team's journey is pretty interesting. We, as a company, we recently transitioned over to Office 365 from on-premise Exchange, which opened us up to a wide variety of services, Teams being one. At the time, when we started looking at Teams, we had a competing product that we were using, and it was basically a product that cost a lot of money to do exchanging of information, message passing, whatnot, between clinicians and users. And we use Teams as a disruptive technology, not only to kind of use it internally as like a dev team and whatnot to collaborate, but we thought, well, what a great tool for our users to use who are already using Excel and Word and all these other different services to kind of come together and collaborate. And the other nice thing is we can inject our own custom software into it through bots and different extensions and give them a more richer experience. We've been able to basically take Teams as a platform and call out to like legacy software that was once hard to call. We've kind of abstracted that challenges away in code and made it nice and easy to present information that was otherwise required a user to go find a PC, log into that application, spend 10 to 15 minutes. We can now give them data and information at their fingertips through a chat client, and they can take that data and pass it to another user and say, hey, can you take a look at this patient? Or hey, something doesn't look right about this lab value. Can we investigate or can we talk about it? So we have that collaborative nature over data, which was otherwise impossible to do. So what excites me about Teams, again, is the ability to have really reliable communications. We've had some pretty poor chat experiences in the past. So to be able to have channels and groups ad hoc or on the fly, and to take some of like, you know, if you have a project with a project manager, to have them be able to have a platform for them to coordinate their work and keep us all in the line. What I look forward to is, again, the more using the bots and the UI tab elements to embed existing applications that we have so that users don't have to remember where to go. They can just be in the Teams experience and click to a tab and then go to that tab and do their work, come back to the chat, and be a seamless experience. Additionally, what we're looking to do is really integrate it with our registration systems. So as patients are coming in to our hospitals, we can create tabs or channels based on that patient to certain groups of clinicians so that they know who their patients are, maybe even before their patient is brought to the unit, so they can prepare and collaborate before time.